Good afternoon. My name is Caroline Jackson, and I'm a principal audiologist at the Children and Young People's Audiology Centre. We are one of the largest pediatric audiology departments in the UK. Today, I will be presenting a case study on auditory neuropathy spectrum disorder, ANSD, where ABR testing was performed using the Interacoustics Eclipse. Today, we will be discussing a brief introduction to ANSD, a review of the case history, review of the ABR results, and I will be discussing the ongoing management plan for this baby. The term ANSD encompasses a wide range of presentations, prognoses, and underlying etiologies. The term encompasses a pattern of results where the ABR is absent or has grossly abnormal morphology at high stimulus levels, otoacoustic emissions, OAEs, and or cochlear microphonics are present. These test results demonstrate the presence of preneural responses, but absent or abnormal neural responses. ANSD is reported to occur in 1 in 10 children with permanent hearing loss. Other terms have been used in the past, including auditory dysynchrony. However, in 2008, a consensus was reached to use the term auditory neuropathy spectrum disorder, or ANSD. In their paper, Rance and Starr, 2015, discussed two proposed disruption mechanisms. One is when the neural synchrony is compromised, and the other is where there is a reduction of the activated nerve fibers. They also categorize ANSD according to site of lesion. One, presynaptic disorders, for example, caused by oxygen deprivation, and two, postsynaptic disorders, where there is diminished auditory nerve activity, dysynchronous activity caused by unmyelinated auditory nerve dendrites, a congenital malformation of the nerve, and a conduction disorder due to, for example, acoustic neuroma affecting the auditory brainstem. This case study is from a baby girl born at 36 weeks gestation via emergency C-section due to concerns about decreased fetal movement. She required resuscitation and intubation after birth. She required 3 blood transfusions due to a significant bleed, 36 hours of phototherapy for jaundice. On day 5 of life, she started having seizures, and she is currently undergoing genetic investigations and on epileptic medication. She was diagnosed with grade 2 hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy, which we know is a risk factor for ANSD. The newborn hearing screen results showed screening OAEs clear response bilaterally and screening ABRs no clear response bilaterally. There are no parental concerns about hearing. She is reported to wake to sounds like the door closing and can be soothed by hearing her parents' voices without them seeing her. In the first appointment, baby was 2 weeks corrected age and results were as follows. OAEs were present bilaterally. ABR in the right at 4 kilohertz, results were less than or equals to 90 dB EHL. On the left at 1 kilohertz, results were equals to 85 dB EHL. And at 4 kilohertz, less than or equals to 90 dB EHL. Therefore, with elevated ABRs and present OAEs, this pattern of results is consistent with ANSD. Here are the test results from the first session. As you can see, responses are of abnormal morphology at significantly raised stimulus levels. As you can see at 85 dB NHL on both ears, I called the traces inconclusive because of the abnormal morphology. However, the external ABR reviewer has said that these do meet criteria for clear response. The green arrows are pointing out an abnormal physiological response at 1 millisecond. We can see from the trace indicated by the black arrow that this disappears on a no sound trial, proving that this is a physiological response that we're seeing. The pink arrow is pointing out a single response at 55 dB NHL on the left. Although the residual noise on this trace is less than 15 nanovolts, it is not quite flat enough for us to be able to call it a response absent. In the BSA recommended procedure for ABR testing 2019, single unreplicated waveforms qualify as response absent if the waveform is appropriately flat enough with no evidence of a response, and if using the Interacoustic Eclipse version 4.4.2 or later, residual noise is less than or equal to 15 nanovolts. This is a helpful and potentially time-saving strategy to use during testing if the equipment you use provides the residual noise value. Here are responses for 1 kHz on the right side. Results indicate some robust ABR responses at high stimulus levels in the presence of OAEs. These results follow the pattern of results consistent with ANSD, and therefore we decided to follow the BSA ANSD procedure and review at 8 to 10 weeks corrected age. At the second session, baby was 10 weeks corrected age. We are now seeing ABR responses down to quieter levels and thus a maturation in the ABR response. ABR responses are still raised in the presence of outer hair cell function, demonstrated by the presence of OAEs. The neurologist has told the parents that her seizures have improved due to myelination. And based on this, we theorize that myelination is occurring centrally and therefore also potentially occurring along the auditory nerve, hence the reason in the maturation of the ABR response. This is still a working diagnosis, and at present, we don't know the effects that her seizures are having on the ABR response. Let's look at the traces. As you can see, on the right side, we are still getting an abnormal response around 1 millisecond coming through. However, the morphology on the left has improved significantly since the first session. On both ears, we are recording ABR responses down to quieter levels. The green arrow is showing a single response, which we have labeled as clear response. This is because the Eclipse provides an FMP value, and where the FMP is greater than 7, the size of the response is greater than 100 nanovolts, and the waveform shows the expected characteristics in terms of latency, amplitude, and morphology, this waveform can be considered a clear response, according to the BSA recommended procedure for ABR testing 2019. It should be noted that this modified criteria is not applicable when the only clear response is recorded at maximum levels or to defined threshold. It is very helpful and time-saving using this modified criteria when using it at levels to define gold standard. Here is a comparison of ABR results between both sessions. As you can see, although the right ear morphology is still quite abnormal, it has improved, with wave 5 SN10 being more robust at the 10-week follow-up. The left ear, where there was no obvious response coming through at 50 dB NHL initially, now at the 10-week review, we are seeing a response coming through which meets the criteria for clear response. Some forms of auditory neuropathy may reflect the attenuation of synchronous neural discharges due to demyelination. The intermodal lengths in auditory nerve fibers are remarkably constant. However, slight changes of intermodal length introduced in regenerating demyelinated fibers could adversely affect neural synchrony. Rance and Starr, 2016. There appears to be a link in the improvement in the seizures based on myelination and in the maturation of the ABR, and thus we hypothesize that this is due to the myelination occurring along the auditory nerve. The external peer reviewer agreed with this hypothesis. Our plan is to repeat the ABR in another 4 weeks, when baby will be 14 weeks corrected age, to see if there has been any further maturation of the ABR. Typically, with ANSD, we perform cortical testing at around 4 months old, and this helps to guide our management plan whether to fit conservatively with hearing aids or not. In this case, however, as there has been maturation over time and we don't know the impact that her seizures are having on her ABR or the impact that they will have on cortical responses, this is unlikely to be helpful. We will aim to continue carrying out ABRs until such time as they are not possible under natural sleep. We will aim to start behavioral testing at around 8 months old. As per the BSA ANSD procedure, we will aim to repeat ABR testing under sedation when she is 12 months old. We will also aim to use parental observations, results from listening development questionnaires, such as the little ears, to monitor her responses to sounds and listening development. ANSD is a term which describes a pattern of results. It is not a diagnosis or a label for a child. This case has proved the importance of pooling results, parental observations, results from other professionals such as neurology, and audiological test results. This case has also highlighted the importance of the follow-up ABR at 8 to 10 weeks corrected age, because sometimes, as is in this case, the ABR responses do show maturation, and it is important to leave the space of time to allow for that possibility, adopting a cautious approach when it gets to diagnosis and management rather than rushing into an assumption. Early support for families of children diagnosed with any hearing loss is vital. ANSD can be very confusing, scary, and overwhelming for families, and thus early support, such as a referral to the teacher of the deaf, is important. Thank you for listening.